Now to an I-24 News exclusive investigative report, a political crisis in Venezuela ahead of this weekend's deeply contested and controversial presidential elections. Thousands of people are demonstrating in the streets. There have been prison riots as well. Political inmates fighting, literally fighting for basic freedoms and food and water. One of those prisoners got a hold of a cell phone. Use it to call up our I-24 News producer and co-host of the Spanish language news magazine N24, Damian Pachter. Damian is with us now in studio. Tell us who this prisoner is, why he's in prison, and really how he got this cell phone to call you to speak about what he's going through.
Well, the prisoner's name is Laurent Salet. He's a political prisoner for several years there. He never went to trial as many of his cellmates. And during these riots that took place in the facility, which is the HQ of the intelligence service. It's not really a prison, but a basement where these political prisoners are being held. They managed to pass each other one mobile and from there to contact their families and the foreign press in order to report regarding what's going on there. So far in Venezuela, nobody is covering it because the national press there, the press in Venezuela, is ruled by the government.
Are these only political prisoners? Is it accurate to say they're political prisoners, or are they criminals too?
No, they are political prisoners because it's not an official prison. It's the HQ of the intelligence service. And you have, we know from first sources there, that we're speaking about women, elderly people, young people who under the age of 18 who have been held there without trial, and a U.S. citizen as well named Joshua Holt, who has been held there under Espionage Act.
All right, and we have, you spoke to him on the phone, we have a soundbite of what he had to say about the conditions living as a political prisoner here being held. Let's listen.
Nos torturan todos los días. Nos cansamos de las instrucciones, de los atropellos. Aquí hay unos espacios, unos cuartos chiquiticos.
Sí.
Sin luz, y ahí encierran a las personas durante semanas y hasta meses y las golpean. Tienen ahí sin alimento, sin agua. Aquí guindan a las personas de los brazos, de las piernas, con esposas, con cadenas.
Deplorable treatment there that he's describing. You spoke with some family members as well.
Yeah, the mother of the American citizen held there, her name is Lori Holt. She sent me a message yesterday, and we can...
You see it on the screen here?
Yeah, she doesn't know the current situation of his son, and she explained that he has no ties to political parties in Venezuela. He's just a citizen who went there to get married with a person who he met online.
Is this a sham election this weekend? Is there international observers to protect the integrity of it?
Well, you know, it's still Venezuela. We don't know exactly what's going on, what will happen there. The United States already said that the elections are not reliable, so there's not much to hope for there. The government has been running the country for 20 years already.
Extraordinary exclusive reporting. Great job, Damian Pachter, and the co-anchor of N24, I-24 News senior producer. Thank you so much for bringing that update.